What's up, Varla fans? This is Shawnee Rick here with another tips and tricks video. And today I just wanted to pass along what I use on my scooter for safety when I'm on the road and also the accessories that I wear. Make sure that you all are safe out there and that there may be some products that I use that you may not be aware of. So without further ado, let's get started. Hey all, Shawnee Rick here once again, and today, like I said, I want to talk about accessories and safety of what I use and what I wear. So first of all, to talk about the helmet. I chose to do an entirely over the head helmet with a visor and everything because as I was riding with, one of these, they used to get bugs in my face constantly, get in my teeth and everything else, and it just wasn't working out well for me. I decided to go to one of these, which is much safer, and you can close the visor down to keep the bugs and other things hitting your face, because that's the worst. When you got something hitting your face and flying at you, you can get into an accident almost, because you almost have to stop. And then for my gloves, I wear mechanic gloves because one, they're more flexible than the driving gloves, I feel. The driving gloves do have the solid metal on the top of the knuckles for like if you skid or something, you don't mess up your knuckles, but you can't mess up your knuckles with these either. And they move, and you can move your fingers a lot easier, and you can grip things better, and you can feel everything that you touch too. So this is why I use these gloves. Jacket that I got here, I decided to get one of these riding jackets. This is the Borlenni Motorsports jacket because of the fact that it's just got a thick vinyl exterior. Pads on the inside right here, I got elbow pads, I got shoulder pads, elbow pads, shoulder pads. I can take and adjust the jacket and pull it tighter around my arm if I want with the elastic here, and I just feel safer. And it's not too hot actually. It does have a liner that you can take off or on depending on the weather. And when you're riding, you almost feel invincible. And then what I got is the Alpha airflow system for my pants, because it has the knee guards, and I got paddings on the thighs here. And I also got pads on the buttocks region as well. So it also has back padding. So if I were to slide, stumble, who knows, crash, I would roll, I would skid, and it's gonna save my bones from breaking. But let me tell you, I've already had a couple incidences where I used to just wear a regular jacket and jeans, messed myself up to where I almost bruised a rib, and then that's when I decided to get all this stuff. And then I did have a few tumbles with it since then. When I did, I didn't even feel really hitting the ground much, and I felt a lot safer. And then of course I come home with no scrapes, bruises, and bumps. So this is just what I wear, everyday rider, my mechanic gloves, my helmet, and then my pants and my jacket. All right, now let's talk about the accessories that I use. So when I first got the Varla, obviously there's no signal lights or anything, but the coolest thing that I found on Amazon was this thing here. This thing here is so cool, and the reason why is not only does it, you know, it flashes like this, so it indicates to those that are behind you that you're there and that they can see you, but it comes with a deal right here on top of the scooter that is a controller for it. The left right deal right here. So you can go left, and then it shows you going left. You can then push right, and then it'll show people behind you that you're going right. Then you can also push straight, and it'll show people that you're going straight. And then you could push stop, and it tells people that you're going to stop. And then all you have to do is just push this yellow button here, and then it will go back to normal and flash again. So this is, as you can see, is attached to my backpack that I use to ride with. I love it. It's a signal pretty much on my back and it's very visible. You can recharge it, it is USB. I leave this attached to my backpack every day and never have any problems with cars behind me, signaling or anything like that. Now the other investment that I went ahead and did is I got myself a Kryptonite Evolution lock. Found this on Amazon too, and this thing is cool. So you can basically strap the accessory around the stem, and then if you push on this little gray deal, it just slides right up and off. So then when you undo the strap on it, it hangs down like this. Then it comes with a key that has even a cool little light attached to it. And you just insert the key, turn it, slide the accessory off, and then you have this deal here that could wrap around your scooter, and then you also have the U part of the lock that you could wrap around too. This thing would take someone hours to even try to break or undo in order to access your scooter. So I bought this, it's been great to have, and I've had no issues when locking it up, and nobody's ever tried to take the scooter or steal it with this. Then the really other cool deal is I was like, man, I wonder if I can get a fob for my scooter and get an alarm system. Well, on Amazon, let me bring the camera around here, they sell this little doodad. And some of you may have seen it and some of you may not, but what this sucker does is awesome. Not only does it act like a horn, but it also comes with a fob that you can arm it and that you can also disarm it. So you push the button, it arms, takes a second, and then that means that now it's armed. And then what happens is, watch, just the slightest little bump and it sounds off. So if someone were to try to grab this thing, there you go. That's how sensitive it is. And then you can just shut it off with the off button here. So it works just like a car alarm. Super handy to have. So you typically wouldn't even have to use the lock. You could just set the alarm and go inside, and if someone were to bump this thing, it'll be heard. And of course you can run out and make sure your scooter is okay. Not only that, but this little alarm system comes with an actual horn. So you can use it as a horn too, which I like better than the little bell that, you know, used to be attached right here. This thing is awesome. It alerts people that you're coming. It also alerts cars and stuff, and it can be heard. It's got a certain good decibel rating to it, and it's super awesome to have. And so I ride with that as well. The other thing is that, as you can see, I got my ride cam, action cam, right here on or the front of the stem also. So that way I can film my rides when I go. The reason why I started putting it here around the stem instead of attaching it to like the helmet was because when I was attached it to the helmet, my head moved around so much because I'm looking around, you know, when I'm riding for safety and stuff, and the images were never coming out without a bunch of shakiness to it. Next thing I use is of course another headlight, because the lights down here on the deck are not that great. They shine out along the bottom of the road and they kind of like show your tire in the front, but they don't really shine in front of you very well. So of course always get yourself a bike light. This one here is an older one, 3000 lumens, and it does pretty good, always should have a light up here for sure, to go with the lights that you have down below on your deck.